Welcome to Gemara Academy. In this class, we will learn Tesis Dira Maschel, Vidilma Hanachu Dalei Baya HaKira Baya. Let's begin. Vidilma Hanachu Dalei Baya HaKira Baya. Here in the Gemara, we challenge the answer of Rabba in his interpretation of our Mishnah that doesn't make it necessary to have a Kira from an area that's 4x4 and an or Hanacha to an area that's 4x4. That this is based on the opinion of Rabbi Akiva. Because Rabbi Akiva holds Kluta Kemisha Hurchadamya, which means that just the item being contained in the ear of a Rishus is as if it's resting there, and therefore, as a result, a person can be chai for the Malacha of Eitzah. The Gemara asked, maybe Rabbi Akiva doesn't make it necessary to have a Hanacha on an area that's 4x4. However, that Kira is necessary to have from an area that's 4x4. So Tesis here is going to present the way Rashi learns this question on the answer of Rabbah. And he'll explain why he disagrees and finds Rashi's explanation difficult, and then he'll present his own explanation. Let's see. Pirush Rashi, Rashi explains, and it's in purple because he's presenting Rashi's interpretation to the teaching in the Gemara, to daik that the Gemara is pointing this out, that maybe it's only regarding the Hanacha that it's not needed on area by that's 4x4, but for the Akira, maybe it does. Midalei Mechayev base, from this that he doesn't make the person Mechayev too. If it wasn't necessary to have the Hanacha on an area that's 4x4, or the Akira from an area that's 4x4, Rabbi Akiva should have said the person's chayef too. He threw the item from one Rishus HaYechad to another Rishus HaYechad over the Rishus HaRabim. When it went over the Rishus HaRabim, we say Kloto Kemisha HaNachadamya. So now there's a Hanacha. So there should be the Malacha of Eitzah. And then when it continued from the Rishus HaRabim to the Rishus HaYechad, there should be another Chayef HaChanasa. Says Tesis, Achas Mishum Eitzah, one for Eitzah, V'Achas Mishum HaChanasa, one for HaChanasa. So from this that Rabbi Akiva didn't say that the person's chayev too seems to indicate that he's only chayev one. So therefore we could distinguish that it's only regarding the Hanacha that it's not needed to have 4x4. Therefore it's chayev one. However, since for that kira it is necessary to have it done from an area that's 4x4, therefore there's no second chayev. The kasha says Tesis, this is difficult. Dilma, it's maybe hadalei mechayev beis, maybe this that he's not chayev mechayev the person to chayuvim. Mishum delay mechayev atulda b'makam avis, because he doesn't make a person chayev and atulda in the place of its av. There are some opinions that hold that if a person does an av and its own tulda, he's only chayev one chiyuv, one carbon chatas. So it's possible that this Rabbi Akiva says chayev and doesn't specify two. It's not because the person is not chayev two things. It's simply because the two over here are an av and its tulda, because it's haitzah, which is the av, and then achnasa, which is the tulda. So there's no indication that the person is not chayev two. From this, that Rabbi Akiva says that he's chayev one. It could be it's chayev one technically as a result of a different din, an external din, which is that a person is not chayev for a tulda b'makamav. V'ayid, and furthermore, the besamach ka'amar Rabbi Yehuda, right nearby in the next piece of the Gemara, Rabbi Yehuda says mechayev haya Rabbi Beis, that when Rabbi says chayev, when a person threw an object from one rishus harabim to another rishus harabim through a rishus hayachid, when Rabbi says chayev, says Rabbi Yehuda, that Rabbi means to say the person's chayev too. Afogav diktoni stam Rabbi mechayev, even though it just says plainly, simply, Rabbi makes chayev. He doesn't say that it's chayev too, only says chayev. Nevertheless, Rabbi Yehuda explains it to mean that Rabbi says chayev, he's mechayev too. So hachanami, here too, Rabbi Akiva, according to Rabbi Akiva, minanole, from where does Rashi know the loy mechayev shtam, that it doesn't make chayev too? Maybe it says chayev, but it means too. As a result of these two difficulties, number one, maybe Rabbi Akiva doesn't make chayev too because he's not mechayev and atulda b'makamav. And number two, maybe he does mean to say the person's chayev too. He doesn't just specify. As a result of that, Tosfos says that Rashi's explanation is difficult. V'nira l'farsh, and rather says Tosfos, it seems to explain. And again, it's in purple because Tosfos now is giving a different interpretation on the teaching in the Gemara. V'nira l'farsh, and it seems to explain the paracha akira baya, that this that he asked that you need akira. Tesis now will explain why we distinguish between the Hanacha, that it doesn't need Dalet on Dalet, and the Akira that it does, based on a previous Tesis. In a previous Tesis, we presented the source for the need of an Akira from an area that's 4x4, and an Hanacha to an area that's 4x4, and Tesis will show us, based on those sources, that we can distinguish and say the Hanacha doesn't need Dalet on Dalet, but the Akira does. Let's see. The Alfinan Mimishkan. We learned from the Mishkan, we said earlier, that in the Mishkan they probably did a cure from an area that's 4x4 and an anacha to an area that's 4x4. It says Tesis, shayunet l'mitevas, and they would take it from the teva, shahoyu behen arba al arba, that did have an area that was 4x4, v'neis them, and they would place it liyad oisei amlacha into the hands of those who did the malacha. So the anacha was not to an area that's 4x4. Previously, Tesis said that the source for needing dalet al dalet is because that's what they probably did in the Mishkan. But the truth is, if we look at it, only the Akira was done from an area that's 4x4, not the Hanacha. So now we have a basis to distinguish and say, maybe Rabbi Kiva, that says Chayiv, was only because the Hanacha doesn't need an area that's Dalad al Dalad. But the Akira does, because the whole basis is in the Mishkan, and that's how it was done in the Mishkan. Well, the Fima Shepirashti Le'el, and according to what I explained earlier, says Tosfos, the second explanation, the second possible source that we need Dalad al Dalad for the Akira and the Hanacha was from a Pasuk, says Tosfos, that we learn it out from the pasuk that says a person shouldn't leave his place. We learn it to mean that a person shouldn't remove an item from its place, and the place of an item is 4x4. Asinami shaper. Now it also makes sense to distinguish between the hanacha and say it doesn't need dalad al dalad, and the akira and say it does. The bakira mari, because the pasuk is referring to akira. It says a person shouldn't remove an item, shouldn't do an akira of an item from its place, which is dalad al dalad. The pasuk only refers to the akira needing dalad al dalad, not the hanacha. So we have a source to distinguish between the hanacha and say it doesn't need dalad al dalad, and the akira and say that it does need dalad al dalad. So to summarize, Tesis presented the explanation of Rashi to interpret why we would distinguish between the hanacha and the akira and say that only the hanacha doesn't need dalad al dalad and the akira does, and it's because Rabbi Akiva only says chayev one. It would have been chayev two. Tesis says maybe he's chayev one for an external reason, when possibly, actually, he's Mechayev too. We don't have any indication that he's not. And therefore, Tesis presents his explanation, which is that if we look at the sources for needing Dalad al-Dalad, we'll actually find there itself a distinction between the Hanacha and the Akira, that the focus of needing Dalad al-Dalad is specifically on the Akira and not the Hanacha. And therefore, we could say that when Rabbi Akiva said Chayev, it's possible that it's only because he holds that the Hanacha doesn't need Dalad al-Dalad. However, regarding the Akira, it's possible that we do need Dalad al-Dalad, and therefore, we can't bring a proof from Rabbi Akiva.